Hello for Thursday, November 6th, and on Wednesday we had a pullback day, kind of expected as we'll show in a moment. This first is just the Dow, this is a daily chart, and you know in the newsletter we said that this top line we'd move once we knew that where the C was. We didn't know whether it was going to be high or low, we had to move it up just a little bit. And so we don't know if these numbers are correct, these letters. You know, this is kind of a little game to look at. It doesn't do much good because you know where we take shorts, you know, at resistance like up here or when it breaks through support, which would be down here and so forth. So what it does after that doesn't matter that much, but it's kind of fun to take a look at. Normally in a triangle, if this turns out to be a triangle, which we'll know if it bounces at D, normally the breakdown or out is somewhere in the last third. Depending on where it gets, if it does get down this far, depending on where it is, it probably wouldn't drop at that point. Now, obviously, if it takes a little bit longer, it could. But we're just thinking, well, maybe we'll get down to, if we get down this far, we'd expect to bounce at this level, then come up at either a breakout at that point or a breakdown from that point and to go lower into December. Anyway, what we have so far is Wednesday, as you can see, a bearish engulfing candle. It consumed the full candle the day before. But of course, all these days up, as you can see, the volume wasn't even above the normal volume. So just this first day was, but all these others weren't. So to lose even all of that, even if we don't go down to this D, to come down this area might be a bounce down at the bottom of all this. So that's one place to look, because it could bounce up and then come down a little bit later, as you know. So we're watching this area for a possible bounce. Let's look at the 15-minute chart and see what we have. This we showed in the blog before the market opened, showing that this is negative divergence. In RSI, negative divergence. Hit its high up here, and the Dow continued to go up further. On Stochastics, negative divergence. The high here, and it was going down. And MACD, real big negative divergence. Look, this high was here on the 29th of October. And it's been going down ever since, and even negative, even while the Dow was making these highs. So all those indicators said we're probably going to break down. There's no way to know that, so the way to do it is with a trend line. So the short sell, as we showed, this trend line would be a break under this trend line. You can see it came down, hit the lower trend line, bounced back up. That would be the second point to short sell, is when it comes back up to test and it wasn't able to get above it. So that's a short sell. If you miss both of those, then when it broke below the 50-period EMA and this other trend line, that was a short. So any of these, you got very nice gains, over 400 points. It closed down 489. So you did very nicely shorting the Dow. So what we're looking at now, we've got some Fibonacci retraces here. 9078 is the first area, possible bounce there. The support isn't exact, as you can move over. 50% would be 8901. That is a possibility. That would probably not be a bad situation. But you can see on RSI, we're already in the oversold area, 23, Stochastics at 11. So there could be a bounce maybe if they cut rates in Europe, even though that'll probably be sold later. That could be a bounce to start things off. Otherwise, look at one of these levels for retraces. And of course, before the open, we'll have the pivot points on the blog. Okay, now, SPX, the same situation. This had a good trend line with a hit here, 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 here. And then as it broke through there, that was the short sell point, and that gave you out of the 52 down, I don't know, I can't see the exact point here, but this is about 75. So this is about a good 20 points anyway. You could have shorted it below this 50 period, but if you waited until trend line, still you made did very well. And once again, that is now in the oversold territory as well. We do have the Fibonacci, which you can look at about 925 and 907. I think this is about 947, 945 area. And on the Russell also was a very nice short. And this did not have the trend line so much as it had this horizontal. And you know, the Dow is a good one for horizontals. It loves to do these. Look at how when it came up this time and hit this line, the second time, it exactly the same point. This is so common for it, as you know. So this was a short sell below 534 or 53045. This was a short, and look how well you did. Another 20 points. That's $2,000 for every contract. You only tied up 500. So real nice. This also, as we showed, a negative, negative, negative divergence. So this was a clean situation. It's gotten down to one support area. The next one's just below about 507. If it breaks through here, those are places to watch. Okay, before we get to additions to the watch, just there's just one SUPG because it ran up 29% on good volume. This is not one recommending playing either way. I just pointed out because sometimes people like to play these that run so fast and leave a big gap. You know, because if it runs some more, maybe you put the Bollinger Bands on your chart and watch. If it gets above those, it may be a short sell. The other thing is just to watch it when it pulls back. Maybe it'll be a buy later. Anyway, we'll watch it. I just wanted to point it out because it was a nice mover. Okay, EXTR. Now, we realize if the market does continue to pull back, some of these won't set up right away. But this got as high as 224, and then 214 was the original place it broke from. You can see it pulled back, but the volume was good. You're not perfect, but better than it has been. So if this maybe pulls back another day or two, I think in the next shot above 214, 224, if we're get back into some bull mode, which I think we will. A lot of people think we'll just drop from here, but there's a lot of charts that look pretty decent now. Now, XTXI, but we are adding several shorts, so we can make it either way. XTXI, below this 850 once again, or its low of the day, which was 830. That's your choice, and that depends on if you're an aggressive trader or not. Realize it may be a little bit oversold at the moment already. We've got ABAT. This has both this nice trend line. It has a horizontal at $3, and both of those are around $3, or you may want to wait 5% more, which would be above 316. If you see real good volume coming in, now this may take a few days to set up. In fact, it may never, but we're watching it at any rate. Above those areas, ABAT does look promising. How about ACTG over 304? Now, I like this big volume, and of course, it's consolidated for a few days, and we'd like to see that. Now, this is a low volume stock, only 113,000, so don't buy a lot of shares if you trade it. We don't show these that often, but above 304 because it had horizontal and the 50-day at the same place, ACTG looked interesting. BRNM over $1.41. This is a pretty good setup. We like these long red candles here. Sometimes they won't make it and they'll fail and fail for weeks or months. But because it had good volume coming up into here and good volume a few times coming up, and because it's tested this bottom at 890 cents and at 88, maybe in a day or so we'll try it again back above the 141 is what we're looking at. That'll put us above the 50-day. And another short would be FBC under $1.34. It broke below this first line, and the volume's been picking up. It still has room that it could drop further. So below 134 FBC, a bank may be a possibility. Jern, this is to watch the 370 area for a possible support on this pullback. We like 3 to 4 day pullbacks, as you know. High volume moving up, lower volume moving down. This day was partly up and partly down, so it had higher volume. And then on Wednesday, it was lower volume once again. Now, you can see that the signals for selling on stochastics haven't even been given yet, but it probably will. But we don't worry about those in the short term. If it can hold this 370, that's the 50-day EMA and horizontal support and the trend line, then watch for a bounce. Or sometimes what we'll do is nibble on a little bit, and then we'll get rid of it with a little loss. You can do that or wait for seeing some volume coming in and a bounce. GERM looks like a possibility. And we have one more short, and that's LWSN under 444. We need increased volume. This lower volume indicates a possibility that it's going to bounce there as it did before, so it could be a double bottom bounce. And if the market turns around, I don't know not much about loss in software, but if the market turns around and this gets down there and holds, you could play it for a long bounce, but I don't like the setup for that because the volume wasn't good on the up, but under 444 could be a short. So that's our additions. Now, I will mention that we do have a couple we're watching just quickly. We're not these on the list yet, but STEM. I think another day or two, maybe we'll fill this gap. We haven't put it on the list. We may. How about also AHT, same situation. Let's give it a couple days, and we may add it to the watch list. But just to show, we watch many stocks, and if they get closer, this one also, CYCL. Anyway, those may come later. We'll find out. So thanks anyway for coming by the site, and I hope you have a good day trading today. And we'll be back again tomorrow with some new ideas. Bye-bye.